Hello and welcome. In this video, we are going to dissect the keyword research tool. With the help of this tool, you can get detailed information about keywords in organic and paid search. More specifically, you can analyze any keyword against a number of key metrics, expand your semantic core with similar and related keywords, as well as see the top ranking organic and paid websites in any keyword SERP. All right, let's take a closer look at how this tool works in practice. Keyword research can be accessed from the top horizontal navigation bar. First off, you need to select a country from the list and enter a keyword that you want to analyze into the search box. If the entered keyword isn't in our 3 billion keyword database, the system will collect all the necessary data in real time. Once the data loads up, you'll be redirected to the overview tab. Here you'll find a summary of everything that's going on with this keyword in organic and paid search. At the top, you'll see several important keyword metrics. The first one is the keyword difficulty score. It tells you how hard it will be to get this keyword to rank among the top 10 search results. To calculate this metric, the system analyzes the quality of the top 10 domains in organic search, as well as the quality of their backlink profiles. The higher the score, the harder it will be to rank higher. Next, we have the search volume. It shows how many times the analyzed keyword is searched for on Google per month. The graph lets you see the search volume for previous periods and allows you to estimate the keyword seasonal trends. If the search volume fluctuates a lot, this can be a clear sign that this keyword is highly seasonal. For example, for the keyword buy sweater, the search volume increases dramatically before winter. But for the keyword fireworks, it spikes right around the 4th of July and sees a small increase around the holiday season. And then we have the cost per click that lets you know how much it costs to get one click from search for this keyword in your Google Ads campaign. Besides the selected country, the graph also lets you see the cost per click in other countries where the analyzed keyword is being targeted in Google Ads. Here, you can also see the Google Ads competition level. This metric displays the ratio between the number of advertisers who are targeting the analyzed keyword and the total number of keywords on Google. If this metric is anywhere between 0 and 0.3, then the level of competition for a keyword is low. If it's between 0.3 and 0.7, then it's medium. And if it's between 0.7 and 1, then it's high. If Google doesn't have enough data, you will see a dash. By examining and comparing these metrics, you can prioritize a keyword in terms of your website's promotional efforts. If each metric is high, then the keyword is very popular and has a high level of competition in both paid and organic search. Targeting this keyword in Google Ads campaigns can be very costly. For this reason, you need to make an informed decision about whether you have enough resources to compete with the top players for this keyword and whether doing so will be profitable for your business. If you find a keyword with a low difficulty score and a high level of Google Ads competition, then that means that this keyword is a great option for organic campaigns, but it is also popular on Google Ads, which most likely means that it will be more expensive than usual to target it in paid campaigns in your niche. But it's important to understand here that the cost per click is an average for all advertisers. And not every one of them engages best practices when setting up ad campaigns, and as a result, pays more. You can look at this metric to get a preliminary forecast, but you will find out the actual cost per click once you launch your own ad campaign. Keywords with a low level of competition can be optimal in terms of the resources that are spent on their promotion. One of the main tasks of a qualified marketing specialist is finding such search queries. In the Keyword Ideas section, you will find search queries that are similar or related to the analyzed keyword, along with various other ideas that you can use to expand your semantic core. At the very bottom, you will find the top 5 websites that are ranking in organic search for the analyzed keyword, as well as a list of sites that are running ads on Google for the same keyword. Even if you're only running organic campaigns, you should also check the advertisers that are running ads for your target keywords. Before launching any campaign, you need to study and evaluate your commercial goals. If there are a lot of advertisers, then you have a lot of competitors, and chances are fewer people will click on organic results due to the abundance of ads. You can get more data on each section either by clicking on the View Detailed Report button or by accessing the necessary section using the left-hand vertical navigation bar. Let's continue by moving on to the Keyword Suggestions tab. With the help of this module, you can build your site's semantic core from scratch or expand an existing one. Under the Similar Keywords tab, you'll find a list of keywords that contain the analyzed keyword or have a different ending. Next to each keyword, we have a list of parameters that can help you understand the keyword's value and quality, namely search volume, cost per click, competition, and difficulty. Besides getting keyword suggestions here, you can also view the top 100 search results for each of the queries along with their traffic forecast, traffic cost, and the total number of keywords the site ranks for. By analyzing a keyword SERP, you can quickly understand which of your competitors are already ranking at the top and either start analyzing them or go to their site. Under the Related Keywords tab, you'll find alternative search queries that have the same pages ranking among the top 100 search results as the analyzed keyword. In addition to standard metrics, you'll also find the relevance column here that shows what percentage of pages in the top 100 search results match for the analyzed keyword and the suggested one. For example, 21 means that 21 identical pages rank among the top 100 search results, both for the search query by sofa and sofa. The higher the percentage, the more relevant the two keywords are. Here you can also see the top 100 search results for each query. Using the filter, you can find the best keywords to target in your campaigns. For example, you can filter out keywords whose difficulty score is more than 30, level of competition is over 0.5, and then sort the remaining results by cost per click. As a result, you will get a list of potentially low competitive search queries that can convert well. You can then export the necessary keywords into a file for further analysis. The last tab here contains low search volume keywords from Google that are not searched for as much as other keywords. As a rule of thumb, they are very specific in their intent and consist of more than 3 words. Such long-tail keywords can help you get keyword ideas that you might have missed in previous research stages. Under the Organic Results tab, you'll find a list of the top 100 organic search results that rank for the analyzed keyword, along with their traffic forecast, estimated monthly traffic budget, and the total number of keywords they rank for in search. All of the websites presented here can also be filtered by any parameter and exported to a file. By clicking on a site here, you'll be redirected to the competitive research tool where you can study the keywords that the site targets and ranks for in organic and paid search, track its ads history, run a semantics comparison of several domains, and do so much more. We have a separate video on the competitive research tool that you can check out by following the link in the description below this video. Under the Paid Results tab, you'll find websites that target the analyzed keyword in their Google Ads campaigns, along with their traffic forecast, estimated monthly traffic budget, the total number of keywords they rank for in search, and a preview of the ad itself. By clicking on the Expand Ads button, you will see all of the ads broken down by month, as well as the copy they used in their paid campaign. On top of that, you can always export the ads in an XLS or CSV file format. Now, besides analyzing one keyword at a time, you have the option to perform bulk keyword analysis. As you can see, it can be accessed from any section of the keyword research tool. With the help of this feature, you can analyze a long list of keywords and get important data on each one from our database. All you have to do here is enter your keywords manually or import them in a CSV file and select a country from the list. As a result, you will get a report on each keyword along with such metrics as the difficulty score, search volume, cost per click, level of Google Ads competition, and organic search results. However, it can happen that you enter a keyword for analysis, but our database doesn't currently contain enough data, including historic data, because the keyword isn't very common or is only popular in a certain niche. For such cases, we have a special feature that allows you to submit a list of keywords to our database for analysis. Just select a country and add a list of keywords, which will then be added to the processing queue. And 3 to 6 weeks later, when we update our database, you will be able to get a detailed report on each keyword. At the top, you can see how many keywords are being processed, how many you have already added to the database, and how many keywords you can still add. This feature is only available under the Plus and Enterprise subscription plans. By the way, if you're in a hurry and you need to get data on a keyword, you can always use the search volume checker, but note that it won't provide you with historical data. That's it! We have looked at every section of the keyword research tool. If you have any questions, leave a comment below this video or reach out to us via live chat. We are always ready to help. If this video was useful, leave a like. And if you want to know when we upload a new video on one of SERanking's many tools, subscribe to our channel. Thank you for your attention, stay safe, and see you next time.